What is up, my fellow producers and caustic enthusiasts? Today I ran across something actually pretty cool. I've been using caustic for, ever since 2016, and I didn't even know about this. And apparently you can access a secret number pad in caustic, which lets you enter codes that some are actually quite helpful. So to be able to access this, you need to go into where it says help and go to about caustic. Now, so imagine the mouse is my finger. I want to tap on the caustic 6 times. So I'm going to click 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this just popped up, secret number pad, and it lets you type in a code which has different effects depending on which code that you enter. Now I searched online and I found about 5 different codes, and none of them really worked on my PC, so I went ahead and hopped on my Android and I got a couple of them to work, so I'm going to show you about them right now. Okay, so here we are in my Android phone in caustic. Now, the first thing I want to show you is actually in the tools, and we go to the standalone wave editor and say that I want to load something. So we go to load, and if you go to home, there's some stuff that I saved into my editor. But if you go back, this is as far as you can go back. This is all the stuff that's in my internal storage. I can't have access to my SD card. So watch again. If I go home and I push back 1, 2, 3, it won't let me go back any further. Now, here is where the secret code comes in. There is a code that you can type in that will give you access to your SD card. And because by default, you can only access stuff that is in your internal storage on your phone. But if you want to access your SD card, let's get out of here. Now let's go back to, let's get out of here. Now go to help. Let's open up this secret number pad. So I'm going to tap 6 times on the word caustic, not the 3.2 or nothing, just the word caustic. So, which is in the top left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now we can enter the code. So if you want access to your SD card, the definition by the code, it says allow browsing past SD card root directory on Android for getting secondary storage. So let's type in 766-83-477. So that's 766-83-477 and hit done. Now it looks like it doesn't do anything. But if you go back, let's go to the tool standalone wave editor. Now, if we go to load, we go to home. Now watch, if we go back, this is as far as it would take me before. Now look, I can still go back. Now I have access to my SD card. Isn't that cool? So that is how you can gain access to your SD card. And if you don't want access anymore, type in the code again and it will take it away. So watch this. Let's type it in again. Out of here, help caustic 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And it was 766-83-477. Done. Go back. Let's go to the tools, wave editor, load, home. 1, 2, 3. There we go. See, now it won't let me back into my SD card because I can't go back any further. So that's how you get out of that.
Here's another cool feature. Say that you wanted to load one of the demo songs that came with caustic. So if we get out of here and we go to song and we go to load, say we want to go to our demo. You're like, wait a minute, where'd my demo songs go? Like, I must have accidentally deleted them. Well, there's a way to get them back. So if we get out of here and we go back to help, and go to about caustic and tap on it 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we can type in the code that says 2679. So 2679 and hit done. Now you can see that it brings us to the screen that says extracting demo content. Please wait. So basically what it's doing is it is re-downloading the demo songs that came with caustic. So now once it's done, we can go back to the song and go to load. And now look, see, if we go to home and then go to demo, there are the four songs that came with Caustic again. So that's a pretty cool feature. Now there's three other codes that I found online, and two out of the three aren't really necessary, and I'm going to show you why. So the first code is 7397, which says show C-SFXR in sample editor tools. Now this is unnecessary because Caustic 3.2 already has that feature in it. So if we go to standalone wave editor and go to tools, we can now go to the CFXR. So if we click on that, there it is. And if you haven't watched my tutorial on it, you might want to check it out because it's pretty cool and very informative. Now that there's another code that says the code is 78367, which says enable experimental stem export. Now this is also unnecessary because we know that there already is a stem export in Caustic 3.2. But let's just say that we had a subsynth. Imagine if we had like eight other machines here, and we wanted to export the stems, meaning you can download. It will separate the files into each mixer. So there'll be like a subsynth, and there'll be like a bass line or whatever ones that you have, and it's good for a VST. And I think I'm going to make an actual separate video on that, going into more depth, because it is actually pretty cool. So say that if we wanted to export the stem, we would go to song and then export, and then right here there is the stems mixer. Right there. So that is already built into Caustic. So that's why that code isn't very necessary. Now, the last one is 5623XX, meaning that you can set the millisecond value for the CPU. Now, it gives a warning saying don't mess with this if you don't need to, because you might mess some stuff up. Now, I was on a forum, and I read that there was a guy on his phone, and he had a heavily automated song which was just eating up his CPU. And he said he put 5623999, and he said it actually helped out quite a bit, and he was able to work with it. Now there is a way where you can free up a little bit of CPU on your device, but really the basic the really the thing that you should most likely do is just upgrade. I mean, that's really going to fix your problem. There is your phones are so limited, with the actual power on them. So if you don't have a really good phone or a tablet or whatever, it's going to struggle, to run certain things. If you have a lot of automation and the CPU is high, you're just going to run into that problem. And one way to kind of fix this is to just eliminate every single thing that could be eating up CPU, like disable your internet, disable your games, disable anything that might eat up your CPU. And that way you can get up a little bit, you'll gain a little bit up, but there's nothing better than to just upgrade, but that can be expensive. So anyways, if you want to mess around with that, the code is 5623, and you can put in whatever you want. But if you need it back to the default, which is 17 milliseconds, it's 562317. Now I have this, I typed it all out and made a text document on it, and it's going to be available for the download in this description. So if you guys want a copy of this to keep around or whatever to have handy, just in case you want to use them, this is available for download in the description. So that's about it for this video. So thanks for watching. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you next video.
Excuse me if my words is slightly slurred. I'm coming back at you like Revenge of the Nerds. I drink my liquor, neither shaken nor stirred. Like a sophisticated, so sophisticated bastard. I'm a miracle maker, turning water into wine. Watch this on my wrist, so you know I'm on time. Now let the beat genuine, and go on pump to the thumb. And drop your to the floor like you was taking a dump.